Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class. Yes, yesterday we were discussing the CET or NEET or JEE model objective exercise 2 from the chapter polymers. Now it is the class 2 on objective exercise 2. Yes, take your volume 4 material, volume 4. Chapter is polymers. And the page number is 141. Yes, question number 12. The question number is 12. Question number 12 from objective exercise 2, volume 4. The chapter is polymers. Question number 12. Read the question. Which one of the following polymer can be softened and hardened repeatedly on heating and cooling without changing its properties? Yes, yesterday we studied about classification of polymers. Yesterday we studied about classification of polymers based on molecular forces. Based on molecular forces, the polymers are classified into 4 types. The first one is elastomers. The second one is fibers. And the third one is thermoplastic polymers. And the fourth one is thermosetting polymers. So yesterday we studied about all of this, excluding of thermosetting polymers. If we consider the remaining 3 polymers, that is elastomers, fibers and thermoplastic polymers, if you arrange these 3 polymers in the increasing order of their molecular forces, increasing order of molecular forces, increasing order of molecular forces, which one is having least or weak forces? Means elastomers are having weak forces between the monomer units, so then we can write the order as elastomers are having weak intermolecular force of attractions than thermoplastics, whereas thermoplastics are having weak intermolecular force of attractions than fibers. So this is the increasing order. Yes, it is important for CET and NEET or JEE. It is a very, very important concept. You have to remember. But here the thing is, you have to know the examples of elastomers. You have to remember the examples of thermoplastics, and you have to remember the examples for fibers, because in the CET or NEET or JEE examination, this order will not be asked. They give some examples for elastomer, one example for elastomer, one example for thermoplastic, one example for fiber. Then you have to find out the correct increasing order of molecular forces. Anyhow, our question is, which one of the following polymer can be softened and hardened repeatedly on heating and cooling? Yes, yesterday I said that if you take the thermoplastic, example for thermoplastic is polythene covers. Simply I can say that polythene cover is nothing but polythene. So polythene is an example of thermoplastic, as well as PVC, polyvinyl chloride, that is also an example of thermoplastic polymer. So thermoplastic polymers, on heating they get softened, and on cooling they become hardened. So for the question number 12, the option is fourth option. Thermoplastics can be softened on heating and hardened on cooling. That is the statement. Yes, see the next one. Next number is question number 16. Very, very important one. Actually, here important means it is not for CET or NEET or JEE. Actually, it is an important concept. So there is no important questions for CET or NEET or JEE. Don't ask for the important questions. Each and every topic is important. So the question number 12. Sorry, question number 16. Which one of the following polymer has empirical formula identical with that of its monomer? Yes, in the first POC, you studied that. How you will get the molecular formula? To get the molecular formula, what we have to take? N molecules of empirical formula gives molecular formula. In the stoichiometry chapter, you studied this one. N molecules of empirical formula gives molecular formula. Otherwise, we can write the formula as molecular formula is equal to empirical formula taken N times. Once again, the question, which one of the following polymer has the empirical formula identical with that of its monomer? Yes, if you take the Teflon, what is the complete name of Teflon? What is the complete name of Teflon? The complete name of Teflon is poly tetrafluoroethene. That is the complete name of Teflon. Yes, Teflon. Yes, the Teflon is represented as F2 single bond taken N times. This is the molecular formula of Teflon. And this Teflon is coming from a monomer. What is the monomer of Teflon? What is the monomer of Teflon? The monomer of Teflon is F2C double bond CF2. The monomer unit of Teflon is F2C double bond CF2. If you say the Teflon here, F2C single bond CF2 taken N times. Taken N times means it is like empirical formula taken N times. This is a molecular formula. Sorry, this is the empirical formula. This is the empirical formula. And this one is the molecular formula. So for the question number 16, the answer is option 1. Option 1. My dear students, when you are watching the recorded videos, just press on the pause button, then simply you can write the notes. If you require, you can simply write the notes just by pressing on the pause button. So Teflon is an example of fully fluorinated polymer. Yes, question number 20. Let's read the question. Natural rubber is a polymer of natural rubber is a polymer of. So here natural rubber, it is an example of natural rubber is an example of polymer. The polymers are coming from their monomer units. Then we have to know the monomer unit of natural rubber. Monomer unit of natural rubber. What is the monomer unit of natural rubber? The monomer unit of natural rubber is, the monomer unit of natural rubber is isoprene. Isoprene. Its IUPAC name is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Important one. Isoprene is the monomer unit of natural rubber, and the IUPAC name of isoprene is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. How that is represented? 2-methyl. Second carbon having methyl group. So this is the first carbon, CH2. Double bond C, single bond CH3. Single bond CH, double bond CH2. First carbon, second carbon, third carbon, and this is the fourth carbon. First carbon having double bond, third carbon having double bond. So 1,3-diene. Total number of carbons in the chain. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons are in the chain. Hence it is called as but. And second carbon having the methyl group. Hence it is a 2-methyl. So isoprene. Isoprene is the common name, and its IUPAC name is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. This is the structure of 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene, and it is an example of unsaturated compound, because pi bond is present here. Here also pi bond is present here. So whenever unsaturated monomers are there, when they are undergoing polymerization, that polymerization is an example of addition polymerization. Addition polymerization. So isoprene units are undergoing addition polymerization, then the obtained polymer is called as natural rubber. So natural rubber is the addition polymer of isoprene. Yes, how it will be, how it appears, how it looks like. Natural rubber. I am writing the structure of natural rubber. Natural rubber. Of course, rubbers are the examples of elastomers. And it is coming from monomer. Natural rubber is coming from a monomer. What is the monomer? 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. 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 Just a minute, ma. Is the board is clear to you? Just a minute. Yes. Once again, the question. Natural rubber, it is an example of elastomer, and the monomer unit of natural rubber is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. That is represented as, this is represented as CH2, double bond C, single bond CH3, single bond CH, double bond CH2. Now, this one, what is the name of this one? Isoprene. The isoprene is undergoing addition polymerization. Here, addition polymerization is again classified into two types. Cis addition and a trans addition. Once again, the addition polymerization is classified again into two types. Cis addition and a trans addition. Whether cis addition takes place or trans addition takes place. Yes, I am taking this carbon, C. Okay? And single bond. This double bond becomes a single bond. CH2. When a pi bond is broken, a new sigma bond is formed. So I am taking this carbon, That is a C. Double bond becomes a single bond. CH2 single bond. And here it is. Single bond CH3. This is the CH3. Right? Between this carbon and this carbon, single bond becomes as double bond. Single bond becomes as double bond C. Here, single bond becomes as double bond. See, this carbon is having hydrogen. This carbon is having hydrogen. This carbon is having hydrogen. This is the one. And here, double bond becomes as single bond. I'm writing single bond. CH2. When a pi bond is broken here, again, a new sigma bond is formed. So, actually, this is the isoprene unit. This isoprene unit is undergoing addition polymerization. Between the carbon and carbon, double bond becomes as single bond. Between the carbon and carbon, single bond becomes as double bond. These units are repeated n times. These units are repeated n times. Then we can write that. Here I am writing like this one. Single bond C, double bond C, single bond CH3. Same, this unit is repeated here again. This unit is repeated here again. Again, single bond, here hydrogen is there, here hydrogen is there. Here CH2 is there, here CH2 is there. So these units are repeated n times. Once again, single bond C, double bond C, left side, single bond CH3, right side, single bond H at the top, CH2, single bond, and so on. These units are repeated n times. So this is the structure of natural rubber. Yes, tell me, whether it is a cis compound or trans compound. Can anybody say whether it is a cis compound or trans compound? Yes, simply you can say that CH2 group is present here. CH2 group is present here. When same type of groups are present on the same side of carbon double bond carbon. Whenever same type of groups are present on the same side of carbon double bond carbon, that compound is called as a cis compound, a cis isomer. This is a cis polymer. What is a cis polymer? Natural rubber is an example of cis polymer. Natural rubber is formed by cis polymerization or cis addition polymerization. Okay, and now it is taken as the first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, and it is the fourth carbon. Because natural rubber is coming from isoprene. Isoprene is nothing but 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Only four carbons are present here also. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons in the chain. This is in the branch. Right. So finally, we can say that this is known as cis 1,4. First carbon and fourth carbon are having continuation. Here, first carbon is continued and the fourth carbon is continued with another units. So we can say that cis 1,4 poly. Poly means these units are repeated n times. Then we can say that cis 1,4 poly isoprene, nothing but natural rubber. Very, very important topic about rubbers. Yes, once again, see the material. Question number 20. Natural rubber is a polymer of, yes, what is the option? Second option. See the second option. 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene. Where is the option? So the option is 2. For this question, option is 2. So what is the monomer unit? 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene represented as CH2 double bond, CH single bond, C. Single bond CH3, double bond CH2. Is it visible to you? Yes. So So that is the monomer unit of
natural rubber, and the formation of natural rubber is a cis addition, and the natural rubber is an example of elastomer. The natural rubber, its IOPAC name is cis 1,4-polyisoprene. Let's take the screenshot. Most important topic, take the screenshot.
Yes, the time is less. Wait a minute, I have to take the attendance. My dear students, every topic is important. Please don't skip the classes. Please don't skip the classes. If you skip your classes, ultimately you are the loser. So please don't do like that. Don't say network issues. Don't say any other things.
At least watch the recorded videos. If possible, at least watch the recorded videos. For the attendance purpose, some students are joining now. Because just I am saying that I am taking the attendance. Some of the students giving information to your friends. As a result, they are joining to my class just now. Yes, you are very sharp in this manner. Yes, coming to the next question. Question number 21, page number 142, question number 21. Can anybody guess the answer?
Of course, so many students are not having even the materials.
So without having materials, how can you understand the classes? And without having materials, without having textbooks, nothing is there with you.
Question number 21. Read the question. Which of the following can be used as a monomer
in the polymerization process?
Monomer in the polymerization process. Monomer in the polymerization process. Yes, if you see the option number 4, yes, what is given in the option number 4? C3H6. It is just like the formula CnH2n. CnH2n compounds are known as alkenes. So it is a propene. Three carbons are there. It is a propene that is represented as CH2, double bond CH, single bond CH3, propene. When propene is undergoing, polymerization, what we will get? If propene is undergoing polymerization, what we will get? We will get polypropene. If you see the textbook, NCERT textbook, in the topic addition polymerization, there you can find polyethene and polypropene. And uses are also given for polyethene and polypropene in the topic of addition polymers. So once again, the monomer in the polymerization process is option 4, that is C3H6. It is just like CnH2n, that is an example of alkene. Having three carbons means it is a propene. When propene is undergoing polymerization, it gives polypropene. So propene is represented as like this, right? Next, question number 22. Read the question and try to say the answer. An example of natural biopolymer. Yes, if you are going through the biology chapters, you can simply guess the answer. Biopolymers. The polymers which are present in the biological systems. Is called as a biopolymer. So our body is containing DNA, deoxy ribonucleic acid. The full form of DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. This is an example of polymer present in the biological systems. So we can say that DNA is an example of natural polymer. Of course, not only DNA, RNA is also an example of natural polymer. So for question number 22, an example of natural biopolymer is DNA. That means remaining three are the examples of synthetic polymers. Synthetic polymers means man-made polymers. Man-made polymers are called as synthetic polymers. Next, question number 22. See the question number 22. Question number 22. Yes, just now it is completed. Okay. Question number 25. Wrong statement about the polymer Buna S is. Here a polymer is given. What is the polymer given? Buna S. Buna S contain two types of monomers. Monomers are present in Buna S. First one is 1,3 butadiene. Second one is S. S stands for styrene. 1,3 butadiene represented as CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH double bond, CH2. This is 1,3 butadiene. Styrene. Styrene means CH2 double bond CH single bond C6H5 phenyl group. So styrene, the formula is CH2 double bond CH single bond C6H5. So whenever a polymer is containing two different types of monomers, then that polymer is an example of copolymer. Yes, okay. And we know that Buna S is an example of synthetic rubber. Rubber means it is a elastomer. So we can say that Buna S is an example of copolymer, synthetic rubber, and it is an elastomer. Yes, see the options. BU stands for 1,3 butadiene. Yes, that is correct. NA stands for sodium. Here, NA stands for sodium. Whether it is correct? It is not correct. NA means we have to write like this, NA. But here, small NA means it is not the sodium. So, which statement is wrong? Wrong statement about Buna S is. Second statement, sodium stands for, Na stands for sodium, that is not a correct. Here Buna means 1,3 butadiene. S means styrene. So you have to remember, Buna S is an example of copolymer, synthetic polymer, elastomer, and Buna S is an example of, addition polymer. Because the monomer units are containing unsaturation. So this is all about Buna S. Take the screenshot. Yes. By understanding this question number 25, you have to answer me question number 26. After the completion of the class, please give me your answer on my WhatsApp number. Once again, my WhatsApp number is 94902-83667. You have to text me on this number only. Yes, about question number 26, you have to respond on that WhatsApp number. Text me about this class. Whether you understood or not, today's class, please give your response in the chat box.
about this class, please give your response. Text me whether the class is understood or not. All the students must give your response. I am recording your